today we're going to run Spacewar, which to me is like we've reached a milestone when the machine can actually run Spacewar. So Spacewar was originally written for the PDP-1. You can see some videos online and stuff. This is a different version written for the PDP-12. So we're going to kind of go from scratch. We're going to boot the machine, and Dawson will tell us about how that works. Then we're going to compile and run Spacewar, and we'll see it on the built-in CRT here.
Well, since I already booted OS 8 earlier, it's still in the core.
Right, since the core is non-volatile.
Yep.
And here's the ignition. So I've got the machine on.
All right.
And so the OS is still in RAM, essentially, right?
Yep. And the magic instruction to warm boot it is a 7605.
So is that an instruction or an address?
Or magic address.
Okay, yes, so you've punched in 7605 here, and now you're going to
start.
Okay, so that loaded the OS, or it executed
yep.
the...
So that should have the OS. Yeah.
So now this machine here, we've kind of talked about this before, but this machine is essentially our teletype. Connected via serial using some modern cards that a guy named Vince Slingstead built. It also serves as our hard drive, correct?
Yes, we're actually running a program called OS8 Disk Server. Written by Kyle Owens, who is actually he's got his code up on GitHub.
Cool.
That's how I remembered how to run it.
Yeah.
And so we have the disk image already attached and booted.
Okay.
This was from the previous run. So this,
sure.
When I hit that address over there, read at block.
Oh,
seven.
I see. So on the right here, we've got the disk server.
Yep.
And that's using one of our serial ports.
Yes.
And this is our teletype, essentially. What's this output here that we're seeing?
Oh, so that is... everything up here is from the previous attempt. And
right.
then this was actually shutting the machine off.
Okay.
And then this was when I started at that magic address over there.
Oh, cool. Okay.
So the dir command on this image does not work right now.
We're not really sure why.
Yeah, I'll dig into that. But Spacewar works.
Okay.
If we tell it to execute SPCWR3, it will
now
compile.
It's loading from the disk. It's compiling, and we see the fun blinking lights in here. And of course, we've talked about how the speaker clicks when a certain bit in the accumulator is one. So here we're loading blocks off disk and compiling, and that clicking is the sound of our oscilloscope, and we have Spacewar. Let's turn off these lights. Oh, cool. Okay, so how are you controlling that?
So it's these first four over here, or the last four over here for your player two. So you can rotate and turn on your rocket engines while avoiding the wormhole in the middle there.
I think that's supposed to be a star.
Oh, yeah.
Because it's a gravitational field. Oh, and you...
And the only way to actually reset, as far as I can tell, is to run into the star. You can warp.
Okay, so that's another button. I was going to say, I know traditionally that was part of Spacewar.
And that's if you hit both of your rotating switches at the same time.
Okay. So if you warp enough, you'll probably crash into the star in it.
Probably. Want to go and reset.
Otherwise, you'd have to reset from the teletype.
Yep.
There we go. Oh, good job. Okay, so which buttons do I use?
So you would use these four here at the end. So the middle two rotate, and the first one will actually move you.
Oh, and I have to, like, turn it on and off. Yep. I just died, didn't I?
Yeah.
Okay, so the middle two...
Ah.
Oh, boy. And which one shoots?
The last one.
What's the first one do?
Your rockets, or your thrusters.
Oh.
So it plays kind of like asteroids.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I died again. So we can keep ourselves warm by the glowing lights down here.
Yep.
All right. Oh, boy. I'm not good at this. Oh, the star destroys bullets. Interesting.
Huh.
I guess I have to die now. Oh, so as long as I keep those down, I'm nowhere.
Yeah, pretty much.
Interesting. Yeah, it looks better in real life. Oh, we crashed. Awesome. Well, that's Spacewar, so... So let's look at the controls again. So I was using these four, which is essentially setting these four bits in memory, in some particular memory address, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you were using these four?
Yep.
So these two switches were rotation in one direction or the other direction, or if they're both on, I would teleport. And this was... fire my rocket engines, and this was to actually shoot. Do you know if this version of Spacewar has options for running or not?
Not as far as I know. There might be something in the source.
Okay.
I haven't managed to get the source open yet, so...
Sure. Okay. Well, a classic element of Spacewar was the star field in the background,
yeah.
And this one doesn't have a star field, of course. So I wondered if maybe that was a... you know, an option you could enable or something like that.
I'll see if I can edit the source code.
Yeah, or maybe it depends on the setting of certain parameters.
Maybe.
Spacewar. Pretty cool.
Yeah.
Thank you, Dawson. And until next time, stay tuned.